challenge, Hutto became the first test pilot for a unique and powerful new prosthetic leg developed by mechanical engineer Michael Goldfarb and his team at Vanderbilt University. The effort was kick-started by a grant from the National Science Foundation.
We were able to develop a early prototype and demonstrated that it could have a leg that was light enough and could deliver biomechanical levels of torque and power.
Version 1.0 evolved into a more streamlined 2.0, computer-controlled with advanced range of motion in the joints.
This is a battery that powers everything. You have a motor here that drives the knee joint, a motor here that drives the ankle joint. This is the whole computer board that essentially tells the motors what to do with the joints.
It has the computing capability on board to work synergistically with the user to provide the torque at the right time.
It's designed to respond to cues from the wearer.
Right before I go to stare us in, I kind of kick my thigh back just a little bit, and just that little movement tells it, hey, you're about to walk up the stairs.
To reduce the risk of injury, Goldfarb's team has intentionally programmed a slight delay into the leg's computer. Hutto confirms it takes less effort to walk compared to the prosthetic he wears on a daily basis.
With my leg, it is harder because it's always a step behind me.
Goldfarb says after years of work, they have sold their technology to a major prosthetic manufacturer.
We'll know in the next few years if these are going to really gain a lot of traction in the market.
And Hutto, who is now studying to be a nurse, is looking forward to one day soon walking tall on a bionic leg.